I'm back. So, we're on day 93, which means we're a little over halfway through. I hope there's another time skip like there was before, because I don't want to do this for another 90 days. But at the same time, like I've said before, I'm determined to see this through till the end, and let's just kind of hope for the best. So Dr. Euthanasia should be a personal choice. That's Dr. Kevorkian, right? Priest notes prostitution increase, so actor Manuel Torreblanca announced completion of film career. So, let's see. Seven from my stream. You know what? I'm still gonna truck along with my asshole nature. Nope. Nope. You're both fired. $10,000, like I fucking deserve. So, I'm gonna fire him. Wow, he came to work drunk and he's failed the last three assignments. And then you. And then we'll just, you know, hope for the best. Let's see, several dozen workers have gone on strike over layoffs and wage cuts. For a while, they were expecting someone from the company to negotiate with them, but this never happened. The protesters have armed themselves with improvised weapons and have started to break down the fence. Wait, let's actually clear all slots. We're gonna send the two drunks. Fine. And I still have two groups of two, so we'll be okay. We hope. Well, there we go. One of them's dead.
11 in progress.
Rape. Inside a booth in the ladies' public toilet, a woman was overheard holding a man against his will and attempting to blackmail him into having sex. Crystal Harrington only vaguely made out part of their conversation and immediately ran to find a phone to call the police. That's kinda sketchy, and I need to preserve my police force. If the guy had been the one calling, then fine. You know, definitely send them out, but... Oh, someone died. Well, that's too bad. Let's hope for the best that that one, like, isn't an actual thing that needs to be, actually addressed. Yeah, the booth is occupied by a couple who were spicing up their relationship with some role-playing games. Yeah. Let's see, what's this? Mr. Boyd, I've had the misfortune of having a family. My only daughter is marrying a complete idiot. She's requiring that the wedding take place on the roof of a skyscraper and as soon as possible, but I want to protect my daughter from making the biggest mistake of her life, so I've organized a grand wedding and reception, and I ask that you arrest the groom at the altar on some monstrous charges, like child pornography, for example. Better for my daughter to survive that horrible moment of shame in front of 100 people than live the shame every day for the rest of her life. Well, since he's loaded, it's probably a good... It probably has good pay. Yeah, we'll go ahead and send them. Mafia assignment. Jack, we have something going down today at the port at, I believe that's 5:54. We wouldn't want any policemen crashing the party. I think $1,500, fine. After they took 25% of my bank account, everyone else can just kind of fuck off. I'm just, you want a corrupt cop, you're getting a fucking corrupt cop. Let's see. Two women tried to quietly pocket some expensive jewelry at the boutique, but the guard saw everything and stopped them and demanded that they turn out their pockets. One of the women then pulled a gun from her purse and began to threaten the store's employees. Well, I can't help you. It's a hostage situation. A security guard reports that an armed man wearing a frock coat burst into the registry office. He was dragging a young girl in a white dress behind him and demanded the staff immediately arrange their marriage. Well, let's hope for the best. 6,000. They might be back in time for me to send a couple people. If not, oh well, I guess.
12-7,
oh, suspicious individuals are never worth it. A waitress says that a suspicious man in a rumpled jacket has been sitting at a table for several hours. He didn't order anything. I brought him coffee and he just sat there staring at me. I'm afraid he's going to watch me until my shift is over. And then the girl stammered, it's scary to imagine. Can't help you. I'm trying to... Ah, damn. People died. Awesome. And a cop died, and the perp escaped, so everything is fucking going downhill now. Like, seriously, everything, I don't understand. All right. Let's see, he said the port, so this ice arena is okay. Without explanation, Karen Sparkle's manager canceled the Freeburg. Wait. Without explanation, Karen Sparkle's manager canceled the Freeburg stop on the incredibly popular singer's tour. She was originally scheduled to perform in town next month, and... I'm sorry. And incensed fans have gathered at the ice arena where the concert was to be held, demanding to speak with Karen immediately. Senior guard Trevor Hernandez sent his men to calm down the crowd, but the guards were severely beaten and the crowd has begun to break open doors and windows. I literally only have 3 cops. Then that's at the port. So, you know, I... $1,500, why not? Why not? Let's see, illegal business activities. I can't help them anyway. Okay, so he's dead, so that makes 4 dead officers in this shift alone. I'm doing a great job, aren't I? Yeah, the man in question was fired from his job today and was just trying to collect his thoughts and figure out how to get by. 1,500. 2 more dead cops, so nothing else can be done today. So everyone else is just kind of fucked. We're not even going to read them, because I just kind of want this shift to pass by. But god damn, that's a lot of dead cops.
10-11,
so that was a legit... wait, I'm not going to read any of them, that's right. Because there's no real point in reading any of them. They all kind of end up being roughly the same. How did the paddy wagon get back here if both cops were killed? Logic. Attempted carjacking. Oh.
So, okay, well, this is something I can do. Not that I could do this today, but why not? So I'm going to just mess around with this a little bit and see if I can find the correct solution. So I will be back. Yay, we got it! Okay, so it's high school senior, and that's great and everything. I don't have two cops to send, and he's on this shift, which means, oops, it'll have to wait a couple of shifts before we can go and catch the guy. Honestly, with this game, it seems like once you hit one bit of bad luck, you're just kind of screwed. Declare dead, declare dead, declare dead, declare dead. I guess I could have just, you know, said that they were all still alive, let the whole city just continue to burn and collect their paychecks until I got what I needed. But, I don't know. I do try to do my job at least somewhat. Minesweeper, most calls are false alarms. Grandmaster Ellen Bourne plays 20 simultaneous games in the park. Beach to boast new Neptune statue.